Hi everyone! In this video I'm going to show you how to develop this upload widget. There is a main card there where we have the main button and we can upload our document, and then all the uploaded documents will be listed here. So if I refresh the page, I have the upload button, I can click it, upload a document, there will be a loading telling us that the document is being uploaded, and then we can see the uploaded document and eventually click to delete it. So let's upload a couple of documents to see how it works, the loading, and then we can upload another document, and so on. Okay, let's dive into the code. We are going to develop it with a React framework. This is a React boilerplate already created with the Create React app. I didn't do much for the moment. We have the index.js with the index.css. Here we are. I just introduced this style to override the browser default style. Then in the body, I introduced the color of our text, introduced the display flex and justify content to align our content horizontally centered. Given a min 8 of 100 VH in order to be sure our application to occupy all the vertical space, and introducing a bit of padding, mainly because I wanted a bit of padding here. Okay, perfect. Let's run our application. npm run start as usual. Probably, yes, it will tell us that the port 300 is already busy because we are running our demo project there. So we allow npm to select node, basically to select a new port. Here it is. This is our file. Let's insert it there. This is our application, upload the file. We can see it here. If we modify it and save it, we see that this is the application we are running. Perfect, so let's develop it on top of this boilerplate. We have our CSS files, and by the way, if you want to install CSS files, you just need to add Node.sass, and this is the link where it tells us to do that. npm install Node.sass. Me, I already did it. We can see it in our package.json. Node.sass, here it is. Then another thing we need to say is that I introduce a very, very, very simple backend file. I use the Node.js Express and the course modules. Let's go through this file in order to see what it does, but it's just a couple of API exposed in order to interact with our frontend. So this is where we require our Express, where we instantiate it. Then we introduce the course package. Basically, course, it allows from our frontend to call an API to a backend that is at a different base URL or port without having the course error. In fact, here by saying our app.useCourse, we are opening our backend to anyone who wants to call it. Then we are declaring our first API with the verb post. It's a slash upload API, and this is the API we are going to use. It's a fake API, of course, that we are going to use to upload our file. I introduced a set timeout in order for the API not to respond immediately, but just to wait 3 seconds before responding with an OK HTTP code. It's 200 and just a little body. Then we have the second API, the delete one. The API, again, a fake API we are going to use to delete our file. It's a fake API, both the upload and the delete, because the backend is out of the scope of this video. We are going to introduce this fake API in order only to allow our frontend to interact with someone, with the backend, basically. And then we are going to run our server by telling it to listen the port 8080. Here we are, and when it starts, it tells us server running on port 8080. We already started our backend, but we can, by pressing Ctrl-C, stop it, and we can place in the backend folder and then type node server.js, and we see that the server is running on port 8080. Perfect, we can now think about our frontend app. So let's start by modifying this file. This is the main file, and basically there we want also to introduce a couple of elements. We will keep this open, it's a demo one, in order to follow this trace. So we will have a main card that we will call the file upload card, and then this is a second component, a list of documents uploaded, and each document is a separate component again. So let's start by developing this main card. We will call it file upload. It's a component we are going to develop, and we need to declare here a state with the use state hook. Okay, and the use state hook is basically a hook that gives us the, of course, you need to import it from React, and it returns us a couple, an array with two elements, the files and the setter. Here we are, use files, and then we can give an array. Well, I can specify an array with a mock data for the moment, then we are going to delete it. Perfect, just a file there. Okay, a file upload. In our file upload card, we need to pass both the files and the set files as properties. Here we are, set files. Okay, let's start by saying that I'm not using a state management here, like it can be Redux, Recoil, or Context API. I'm just passing my properties, as it is a simple widget. I'm passing my properties through props drilling, let's say. But in a bigger application, those properties passed by the parent to the children will be introduced into a state management. Okay, so let's develop this one. Let's introduce a file upload folder where we insert a file upload.jsx component. Here we are. I'm going to leverage a plugin, a React plugin that we have, in order to introduce a React arrow function export component. Here we are. It is called file upload, and it's fine for us. As we said, we want it to receive the files and the set files. We are going to destructure the properties received. Then we will have an upload handler function. That is a function we are going to declare soon. For the moment, let's define an empty arrow function. And there, inside the component, we are going to develop this card. So we are going to have a, first of all, a fragment, then a div with a class name file card. Here we are. Then we are going to introduce our file inputs. And we will see. It's quite difficult to style an input with file type file, so we need to play with our styles in order to create a transparent, let's say, file input there, because a native file input will be like that. We will see if I declare an input and the type file, it will be, we will see how it is. Now we need first to correct this unexpected token in app.jsx. Let's see. Okay, file upload is not defined, so we can import our new created component. File upload. Okay. We see the type file. Here we are. This is the native input file component, but we don't want it to be styled like that, but like this one. And we can't style so much an input with the type of style. What we can do is to create a div that wraps it and play with the styles, as we are going to see in a couple of minutes. I'm going to declare here a button and element, and then we are going to introduce Fontosum in order to have this icon. In order to introduce Fontosum, we can basically, here it's the link where it tells us what to do, but more or less it's only three libraries to introduce. It's those one that you can copy and paste into your command line, and the Fontosum icons will be at your disposal. So we are going to use here a Fontosum icon. Okay, it has imported it for me there, a Fontosum icon, and then we can specify the icon we want, and the icon we want there is FA plus. We have the autocomplete helping us and importing it for us. Perfect. There we have the button, and if I save it, I can see there the button with our icon. And then we can just introduce a couple of other paragraphs with the main class for the info to the user about the supported files. and also another paragraph with the info of the extensions. So let's say it's a PDF, JPG, and PNG. Okay, so let's style this first card, and then let's think about this upload handler. And to style this card, we can import a CSS file, import, and we call it as our file, so file uploader.scss. Sorry, file upload. Let's define a new file there, file upload.scss. And there we can basically style our card. Here it is. So we have a div with file card class. It's giving us an error. Here we are. Okay, this file card, we can first of all introduce a background color. Of this background color, here we are, we see it. Then we can introduce a border, a dashed border, 3 pixels dashed, and let me copy the color. Here it is. Then let's introduce a padding of 1 pm. Perfect, let's style our content in order to be centered. First of all, I'm going to introduce a min width of 380 pixels and also a min height of 230 pixels. And now we can style our component to be centered. And as usual, we can leverage display flex with justify content center and align items center to center the content horizontally and vertically, respectfully. But then we see that the content is aligned, but horizontally aligned. We want in this case it to be vertically aligned, and with display flex, we can specify the flex direction column. Here it is, in order to align it vertically. Then we can style our file inputs. This is this ensemble of elements. Sorry, here we are. Let me copy this class and style it. Okay, so we need to specify the position relative, we will see later why, and a bit of margin at the bottom of 1.5 em. Here it is. Now let's style its content. We have this input that should have a position relative because it is the text input that is going to occupy the space, and then we will have the button that is position relative with respect to its parent, and it will occupy all the space. The button will have an opacity of 0, so it will be basically transparent, and we will see the input first and then behind the button. And as the input has a is transparent, basically, we are going to see the button. So our input file will have a position relative. Let's give it a max width of 200 pixels, a height of 46 pixels. Here we are, and now let's first style our button in order to understand how it is going then to be present the input. Let me copy the style for our button there, and let me tell you what we did. I copied and pasted there. It's just in order for you not to see me typing all this style. So the button is this one. It has an icon inside and also a text that I forgot to insert with an upload sentence. Okay, we want this button to be positioned absolute with respect to this one and to take all the space of the parent widget. And this is what we are going to do it there. Position absolute, top left 0, and the width and height 100%. Then the Z index of our button will be 1, and the Z index of our input will be 2. In this way, the input will be on top of the button. I'm going to save it. Here we are, we have the button behind, and the input will be on top. Then we have display flex and justify and align items in order to place the content inside of our button centered, a bit of a color, background color, increasing a bit the font size. We want the cursor to become pointer when we are going on top of it. We are going to introduce it also to our input. Here we are. If I save it, we can see our pointer, that our cursor that becomes a pointer there, then a bit of border radius, border none and outline none. The background color, it will be transitioned because when we hover on it, we want it to become a bit darker. You can see it. And a bit of box shadow. Anyway, I'm going to introduce all the code in the description, the GitHub repository. I'm going to introduce the link into the description. We are going to style the icon, this icon that is present there. And now we see that we still have a problem. We see that we have an input on top of it that we can see it, and we don't want that. So what we can do is here we can set the opacity to zero. Here we are. And now we can see that our input is styled as a button. And when we click it, we can open the file. This is a bit of style in order to center everything and the hover aspect. I'm seeing that I need to introduce just a couple of styles there. So app.jsx, then app.scss. Here we have our class title. We can just say that the font weight is bold. Here it is, and a bit of margin at the bottom of 1 am, increasing a bit its size. Perfect, here we are. So now that we saw the style of our card, we can proceed and develop the upload function in React. As I said, let's close it in order to have more space. We have here this input with the type of file. We can just introduce our classic onChange event handler, upload handler, and we need to now fill this upload handler that we declared before. Let's do it now. So basically, the upload handler will receive the event of the input, and inside the event, we will have the file selected by the user, and it will be there. Const file, it will be contained into event.target.files, the first element. Here we are. This is the file we are going to have. Then we are going to enrich this object with the isUploading set to true. We will see later why. And then we need to set our files. It's a setter passed by the app.js, this one, we are going to pass it there. We can add the files that we have just added to our files, basically. So we are going to do that in this way. We are going to destructure the array of files that we already have. Here it is, and we are going to add our files to this array. We will see it later appeared there when we develop the list of files. And then we need to call the backend API in order to pass this file. And theoretically, not theoretically, in a real project, the file will be passed to the backend. The backend probably will add it somewhere, for example, in a database. And then it will return us the file enriched with the ID. And then we will consider this ID everywhere in our application, this file ID, as a unique identifier. In our case, our fake backend is not answering us with an ID, but it's answering us with just a result with this JSON, a JSON that only tells us that the result is true and the message. So we can't rely on an ID generated for us by the backend. We need to rely as a unique identifier to the file name. So let's call the backend in order to upload the file. And we upload the file with a form data native object. Form data, here it is. Then we need to append our file to the form data, and we do it like that. Append. We need to specify a file identifier. Let's use file.name again. Then our file. And then the file name we want it to give, and we give it the real file name it has. And then we can use the HTTP call to pass our file to the backend. To call an HTTP API, I'm going to use Axios. I have already installed Axios. Here it is in my package.json. You only need to do npm install Axios in order to install it. So we can call our backend API, and our backend API, here it is. It's a post API with a URL upload, and it's on port 8080. So we can say axios.post. We can specify the URL, so http localhost on port 8080 slash upload. Here we are. And then we can pass our form data to the backend in order for it to take this form data, for example, save the file into the database. It will receive us a promise, so we can provide the callback of the fulfilled promise with the result that actually we are not going to use. Here it is. Now we have our file. We have set before calling the backend file dot is uploading to true. So in this case, we can copy those two lines because we are going to set the is uploading, it's no more to true, so it's false. And then we can set the files with the ones that the parent gives us and the new file with is uploading false. We can also consider the event of an error, a catch. Here it is, error, and provide the callback even there. So in this case, we can properly inform the user that the upload files result in an error, but in our case, we just want to log this error. Let's say inform the user. In our case, I just console.error and I log the error. Perfect, but I want also to remove the file that we are going to place there. So I call a remove file, and it's a function to which we are going to pass the file.name that is a unique identifier. We do not have yet the file.name. We do not have yet the remove file, so we need our parent to pass it to us. Here it is, remove file. Let's go in the parent and let's develop it. It's a very easy function. Const remove file. As we said, we are going to specify as a unique identifier the file name, and it's basically in our case a function that will set our files. It will filter our existing files and remove the one which name is equal to the one passed. So it's basically files.filter. We will filter file, perfect, then file.name that is not equal to our file name. Here it is. So we have our file name. From our array of files, we are going to filter all the files whose name is different from the one we are going to pass. Then we need to pass to our component again the remove file. Here it is. Let's save it. Here it is. Now we are going to upload our file. For example, this one, our files, let's console log it. Let's console log our files. I refresh, I restart it again. Open the inspector. Here it is. We are going to see that we see the first file, the mock file we have there, but also the second file we have uploaded with its name, and it is uploading false. First, we had only our file name, and secondly, we had our is uploading false after the backend responded us. Okay, perfect. Now let's develop our list of files, and in order to develop it, we need to add it to our main file. So let's add a new component that is our file list. Again, we are going to pass the files because obviously it will need to know which is our array of files. And also we need to pass the handler to delete our file, that is our remove file handler. Here we are. So if I save it now, it will give me an error because we haven't declared the file list. So let's import the file list from, we are going to create a folder with our component filelist.jsx, and we are going RAFCE, React Error Function Component Snippet. Here we are, we exported it from there, and we can import it here. So it's filelist. If I save it, here it is. We can see that it is there. And we are going basically to, let me close everything else, to develop it here. This is just an unordered list, as it is a list of files there. This is the result we are going to achieve. So this is an unordered list with every file list item inside. class name file list. Sorry, let me introduce this one, a file list. Perfect. And then we are going to receive there the properties. We are going to destructure the files and remove file handler. And so here we can map for every file, we can create our file items. So just to be sure that the files exist, files.map, we can have f and then a file item. So here it is. We need to create this file item. Let's create it. Again, we are going to add, first of all, a folder, and then we are going to create a new file, JSX, in which we are going to leverage the plugin in order to create a boilerplate for us. Perfect, here it is. And also to introduce an SCSS. Sorry, let's save it and create this SCSS file. Perfect, we are ready now. Let's save everything, let's go there. Let me see if there is an error. File item is not defined in our file list. Okay, we are in our file list and we declare a file item that we created, but we need also to import it. Cannot resolve import file item from. While it's not working. Ah, okay, because we are here inside, we need to go back to the parent file item should be okay. Perfect, here we are. So we need to create this file item. Let me try to write something in order to see that something happens. File item here, here we are. And we can see that if we add a new file, we will have another file item that it will be present there. So let me React wants that when we are going to map and create a new element from an array, it wants, for performance reasons, the key. As we said, we are going to use as unique identifier the file.name. Then we are going to pass to this object the file. And this is our f declared there. That is each element of the file array. Then we are going also to pass the delete file handler, and we need to declare it inside. This delete file handler will do a couple of things. It will call the parent remove file to delete the current file at the front end, but it will also call the backend to call that API delete, upload of verb delete, in order theoretically to delete it from the database. So we need to declare an handler that we are going to code. Delete file handler. Perfect. Now it tells me that delete file handler doesn't exist. We are going to define it there. Okay, we have our files and remove file. Perfect. Here we are, and we are going to call basically axios.delete. Again, I'm going to copying the base URL. We are going to call the upload, and in a real application here we are going to pass as a query parameter also the ID that was generated by the backend. But in this case, our backend, when we uploaded it, didn't generate any ID for us, so we need to count on the name as a unique identifier. We are going to call this backend API, passing them as a req params, query string params, the name of the file, in order for the backend to understand which is the file that it has to delete. Okay, again, we will have a then and a catch callback. So here it is, our then callback with our res. And we are going just to call the remove file, passing the name. Here it is. Sorry, this is not correct. This name is the name we are going, let me introduce a couple of spaces. This is the delete file handler. It's a function that wants the name there. This is the name of the file we want to delete. We pass this name to the backend, and we pass also this name to the remove file parent function. Here it is, that will take this file name and filter the current array of files with respect to that file name in order to remove it. Then we also want to create a catch for the failed callback. Console.error, and we are going to log the error. Perfect. Here it is, file item there. Perfect. Now we only need to develop our file item into our file list, something like that, that will have an icon, the name of our file, of our uploaded file, and then this icon. And this icon will be either a loading GIF or an icon in, to allow us to remove the file. So let's develop it. Let's close all the other files. File item, here we are. As I said, this is an unordered list. We are going, in this case, to use a list item there, a list item with a certain class name of list item, a key, obviously, as we said, and the key will take the prop file that the parent is going to pass us. The file list is going to pass our file property and the delete property. The file property will of course contain the file, and the delete property will contain the call to the backend to delete the file and to remove the file from the frontend. So that we can destructure the properties that we are receiving, the file and the delete file. The key will be the file.name. And here inside we can place our Fontosum icon. I hope that the autocomplete gave me that. Here it is. Almost. Fontosum icon. We need to import it. I'm going to import it from there. Here it is, our Fontosum icon. And we need to specify the icon we want. And the icon is called like that. It's FA file, sorry, FA file alt, the autocomplete already gave me that. Here it is, this is our icon. Then we just need to specify the name of the file and the action that tells us if the file is being uploaded or if the file or if we want to remove it. So we are going to introduce a paragraph with simply the file name. Here it is. And then we are going to introduce the actions. Here we are, class name action, where we are having a different icon if we are uploading the file or if we are not uploading the file. File dot is uploading. And this is the variable that we are going to set when we upload the file. Let's see it again. If we open the file upload component, we are going to see that when we call the upload handler, first we set this is uploading to true before calling the backend, then we call the backend, then once the backend answers us, we set this property to false. And we can leverage this property to show the loading icon or the delete icon. So in case the file is uploading, I'm going to copy the Fontosum icon we want to insert. Here it is. So it's a FA spinner. So in case the file is uploading, we are going to introduce this Fontosum icon of type FA spinner and the class FA spin in order to rotate it. And we are going to call the delete file handler. This is the file that it is passing us basically. And we can in this case close this one. Sorry, let me check it. Here it is, delete file. We can close it there. Perfect. Let me gain a bit of space. Here we are, I saved it. And now I copy this element, but in this case, we are going to consider the case where we are not uploading the file. So if we are not uploading the file, in this case, we want another icon to delete the file. FA trash, we don't need the spin. And we don't need, actually, this delete file was needed for the trash. In this case, we don't need it because we are not going to click it. Here we are. Now I can save it and we can style this file item file. It's an li, as I said, we have a list style. We don't want it. So To recap, we have the LI, we have a first icon, this one, then we have the paragraph, and then we have the actions icon. Let's style them. So we have list style none. Here we are, we see that the dot disappeared. Then we introduce a bit of margin, 1.2 AM and 0. Here it is. In order to see the result, let me introduce a couple of other fake file. Let me save the file there, save it. Here we are, we have three types of files and we are going to style them. We are going to introduce a background color of this type. Is an RGBA color with a bit of transparency. Here it is, border radius of 5 pixels. Let's enter the content. Here we are, our border radius. Let's enter the content again with the display flex and our align items set to the center. Here it is. Then we are going to introduce a bit of padding, 1.2 AM and 1.5 AM. With these two properties, we have centered the elements, but vertically, not horizontally, because horizontally we want them to start from the left side. Then we are going to style our SVG, our icons, and we are going to color them in this way, perfect. And we are going also to style a little bit, to have a little bit bigger the first icon. We are going to achieve it in this way. An SVG that is a first child. In this case, by saying that, we are telling, let's pick the SVG that is also a first child of its parent. And we are going to increase its size, font size 1.2 PM, and a bit of margin to the right, actually. Margin right of 0.8 AM, perfect. Here we are, let's style a little bit the paragraph, because actually we want this file name to occupy all the space there, to stretch through all the space, and we can achieve that with flex one, perfect. And then decrease a bit its font size. And then the last thing we need to do is to style this icon. Those icons are inserted into the actions class name. Just justify self flex end in order to be sure they stick at the right. To have the cursor pointer when we hover over them. And then to style the spinner in order to increase its size. We are going now to see the spinner in action. Font size 1.2 AM. Here it is. So now we have this one. We can see that if we invert the condition, basically, if we save it, we can see that when the file is not uploading, this is the case now, we are going to see the spinner. And this is this one, a face spinner with the class name a face spin. In fact, Fontosum allows us also to have just a very simple spinners. If we don't want to create our custom spinner, we can also leverage Fontosum icon library. It's perfect. It is what we are going to do now. So now let's see our application in action. We are going to remove these mock files, and to do that, we are going to move there and there, and just to comment those lines, first of all, to comment them. Okay, let's refresh our application and let's see it in action. We are going to create our first file. It will go through the backend. Let's see it again. The backend will call a set timeout. It means that it will execute the content of the set timeout, the callback, only after a certain amount of time that we specified there. And we specified there in terms of milliseconds. Here we specified 3 seconds. So after 3 seconds, the backend responds to us. So our file upload that at first it had loaded and added to our array the file with the is uploading true will change the content of our arrays with a new file with is uploading set to false, and so the icon we switch from loading to delete. We can see it in action again, then see that we can upload another file, and we can also delete the file. When we click there, basically we are clicking on this icon, calling the delete file. The delete file is the callback passed there that will call the delete file handler. Again, the delete file handler will call the backend delete API. Here it is, that will respond, that will answer to us with a 200. It means an OK code, a success code. And so our file list will also remove it from the back, from the front end, and it will remove it from the front end by calling the handler remove file. The handler remove file was declared there into the parent and passed through props. The parent will basically filter our files and take out the element that has the file name equal to the file we have. Basically, it will keep only the file with file name different from the one passed as a parameter. We can see it in action. Here we are, then we can upload another file. Perfect, guys. We arrived at the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I think it's quite simple, but a bit complex to upload a widget, a complete one. It can be improved in several ways. For example, we can introduce a progress bar where we're going to specify the amount, the progression, sorry, of the upload. It can also be improved, for example, by allowing the upload of the multi-files. It means to upload more than one file for every time. In this case, I wanted to keep it like that. Please go and check the code that is in the description of the video. If you liked the video, please click like, subscribe to the channel, stay tuned, and see you to the next video. Bye!